Moms and Matriculation Higher Secondary School welcomes you for online class. In this English class, we are going to see Poem 1, Sherlock Holmes. Unit 1, Classic Detectives. This poem was written by John Nathan Hilliard. He was an American author, drama critic, and journalist. This entire poem is a dedication to the greatest detective of all time, Mr. Sherlock Holmes. And the poet was interested in magic and toured with Thurston for 10 years. The poem written by John Nathan Hilliard, and the poem name is Sherlock Holmes. We may be aware of this character. Sherlock Holmes is a fictional character created by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, and he is known for his sharp wit and quick mystery solving ability. The character is designed in the form of narration by his friend Dr. Watson, and 221B Baker Street, London is known worldwide as the residence of the fictional genius private detective Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes is very famous for his quick thinking and solving the problems quickly, and whatever he just get the cases, he'll discuss with his friend Dr. Watson. And 221B Baker Street, London, this is Sherlock Holmes' address. And it was a fictional character, fictional story. This address also was fictional, but people believed Sherlock Holmes, so they started writing letters and sending to this addresses. So now this address is alive. This address became real. Now this address is there in London. Now we'll see this poem line by line. Sherlock Holmes by John Nathan Hilliard. When Sherlock Holmes, ingenious man, pursued his strange career, we followed his deductions with an interest sincere. Sherlock Holmes is an ingenious man. That means intelligent, clever man. The poet considers his career as strange, as he would have easily pursued other top careers in London. His conclusions were based on strong fact, which the reader enjoyed a lot. We know Sherlock Holmes is a famous private detective, and also we know his observation power and solving the problem. For his knowledge, he would have got some better jobs, but still he was pursuing the same career as a private detective. Although in his time his victories monotonous became, we must admit that since he quit work, life's never been the same. The poet feels that he is victorious in all the cases. Whatever he takes up the cases, he will solve the cases. But the way he approaches each case seems to be quite interesting and very different from one another. This shows that he never picks a case that has the same pattern, but something that might appear silly to others and needs a special attention. Another few lines. He always kept his wits on tap. He always had a clue. He always could foretell just what a criminal would do. A bit of string, a button, a strand of hair on a coverlet made up the only evidence that Sherlock Holmes need get. Here the poet says Holmes always had a clue from the crime scene. His sharp wit enabled him to capture the criminals with minimal clues. Actually, Holmes doesn't need much clues. Whatever clues, a minimum small bit of button or a small hair on the blanket, also from that also, he could get clues and able to solve the cases. Next, and when he bagged his man and had him safe behind bars, he tell the tape to Watson over coffee for 2 hours. His friend Watson then would spin a yarn from the details of the case and label it the token tree or mystery of a face. Next, what happens? Holmes never punishes the culprits on his own. Instead, he handles them to the law and lets them take from then on. He has a friend named Dr. Watson with whom he discusses all his cases. And most of the time, they would solve the cases together. Watson is the narrator of the story of Sherlock Holmes in the original novel. The next 8 lines, we have detectives who are shrewd, detectives who are wise, detectives who, like M. Leacock, are experts at disguise. We have detectives whose brave deeds would fill a dozen tomes, but never one that can compare with Mr. Sherlock Holmes. These lines says that there are several detectives who are wise and shrewd, like M. Leacock, who is an expert in disguise. And there are several detectives whose stories might go down to fill several pages, but none could be compared to the all-around quality of Sherlock Holmes. Here, there may be characters like M. Leacock, expert in detective and disguising, but no one could be compared with Sherlock Holmes. Because Sherlock Holmes, the poet thinks that Sherlock Holmes is the only person can give different solution for the cases. His intelligence giving solution for the cases cannot be compared with other detectives. Dupin's remark, deductions, we today would rather slow. For Sherlock would have solved the case in half a day or so. The novels of Gabarito, the tales of Mrs. Green, were tossed aside when Sherlock Holmes appeared upon the scene. Here, Dupin is another writer whose work remark might look slow when compared to the investigative skill of Sherlock Holmes. The poet says that Holmes would have solved the same case within half a day. There are several other detective novels from well-known authors like Gabarito and Mrs. Green. But once Holmes appeared on scene, the rest of the detectives lose their screen presence. That is the dominant nature of Holmes in terms of wit. Here is to Sherlock Holmes, and may his glory never dim. And here is to his friend Watson for his faithfulness to him. And here is to Conan Doyle, may he attain the prophet's span and all his life just write of Holmes, that great and noble man. At last, the poet makes this entire poem as a dedication to the great Sherlock Holmes, his friend Watson, and to the creator of the fictional character, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. He wishes that the glory of the character Sherlock Holmes may never dim in future also. He calls Holmes' friend Dr. Watson faithful, as he always accompanies Holmes in all the mysterious cases. Conan Doyle has attained the stature of a prophet as he immortalized and being an inspiration for several aspiring detectives. All his life, Conan Doyle has dedicated to his most intelligent character, Sherlock Holmes. Thank you very much.